among the six topics, I have chosen thermodynamics, and I will be discussing first law of thermodynamics. So before entering the first law of thermodynamics, I would like to say what is thermodynamics. So in physics, there are different branches in physics: classical mechanics, quantum mechanics, photonics, thermodynamics, atomic physics, molecular physics, and so on and so forth. So what is this thermodynamics of what about? Thermodynamics, we look at property of a system where there is large collection of system, large collection of particles. Large collection of particles, and we are looking at the system property. So we are looking at the total system property. So someone asks you, in this room, what is the temperature of this room? You take a thermometer and measure the temperature, and if it reads 25 degrees Celsius, it doesn't mean that all the particles are having 25 degrees Celsius. There might be some particles having 30 degrees Celsius, some particles might be having 70 degrees Celsius in an average. So in thermodynamics, we will be always talking about average system property. Right? So these average system properties are known as macroscopic properties. Macroscopic property which you measure. And there are things like microscopic, which is the detail analysis, which we are not interested in thermodynamics in the detail information, microscopic information, but there is indirectly a link between these two. If you know the microscopic property, you can know the macroscopic property, that is statistical mechanics. How we can obtain the macroscopic property from the microscopic, that is statistical mechanics, that is a different branch, another semester course. But in thermodynamics, we are looking only on the macroscopic properties. And this was derived during when Newton's relation all came out, and this is purely based on experimental observation. Experimental observation, you don't need any much theory. You go to the lab, do the experiment, obtain the results. So all these equations which you see, PV equal to NRT, everything are like experimental observation. Right? So what does the first law of thermodynamics says? It talks about energy conservation. Energy conservation, that means energy can neither be created nor destroyed, it is only been transformed. And this is for the first time we are talking about the relation between heat and work. Till now we did not have any relation, something like that. We are talking about heat and work. So delta means heat, and we are talking about work, right? And always I will be talking about some systems, and usually in all the test books you will be seeing this as the case. There is a moved piston and there is a gas molecules here, usually monatomic gases. The reason is Madhyamati language are monatomic, the reason it will be clear. Because you want the system to be very simple. If you want to calculate the internal, how much is the energy of the system, if it is monatomic, like neon gas, only there is one atom, it's only kinetic energy, half mv square. You don't need to talk about rotation energy, vibration energy and all those stuff. So the total energy or the internal energy is purely kinetic. But you can do it anything else. So usually this is the case, more system. Thermodynamics were derived during the period when steam engines were running. Adonna ani kada ga moved pistons are varunadu. That's not out of the just like that. Right? So all this Carnot engine, reversible engine, refrigerator, everything will come like this. So this is the introduction part. And there are many laws of thermodynamics to be studied. So I will be talking about the first law of thermodynamics, which says that if you take a system, the change in internal energy is equal to amount of heat added to the system minus work done by the system. Chela Google has the plus one. In that formula, the formula will be Q added to the system plus work done to the system. Are you clear again? So you can just imagine all these gas molecules are moving apart. Suppose you have kept so many stones over here, and there's a pressure exerted by all these stones downward, and all the gas molecules which are hitting the piston is also exerting a pressure. In equilibrium, what will happen? All these pressures will be